Hello again, this is Miss Lourdes, and today we're going to be painting a still life. We'll be studying Paul Cézanne's still life with skull. The skull and fruit in this painting are symbols for life and death. Here's an example of how your painting might look at the end. So let's begin. Here, I have already created a border on my paper using a ruler and masking tape. This is so that I have room to touch my paper without touching the wet paint. First, we will start with a light sketch of the fruits and skull, so just follow along as best as you can. I'm going to make some general shapes first to see where everything will be placed, and then we'll define things a bit more later. This line is for the table surface. Here I'm drawing some creases for the fabric. Now let's draw the face of the skull. Here we'll better define some of the shapes that create the fruits. Hope that was easy to follow along. Now that we're done with the sketch, let's erase some of the lines we don't need before we start painting. Alright, let's begin by adding some water to our paints to get them ready. I'll be using this extra sheet of paper to mix and try out some of my paint mixtures. Let's paint the skull first. I am mixing orange, yellow, and brown to see if it gives me the tan color that I want. I add some shadows with more brown in the eye sockets. Now let's move on to the first fruit. Here I am mixing yellow and green. And a little bit of orange and brown as well. For this next fruit, I'll be using orange, yellow, and brown. Same goes for this next fruit. This fruit will just be yellow. For this pear, I mix green and brown. Notice that the paint is slowly starting to blend together across fruits. Here I've made kind of a slight mistake by painting things that are too close to each other. So I will be more careful next time and paint the farthest root and paint everything else once those parts are all dry. Here I'm removing some of the paint that has blended in. Alright, so before you move on, make sure that all your paint is dry so that you can paint the rest of the objects. Fast forwarding, now that the paint is dry, I'm going to paint this last fruit using green, orange, and brown. Next, I'll move on to the cloth. I mix blue, brown, and green, and I'm only going to be painting the places where there are shadows and the folds of the fabric. This next part is where I did the background. I blocked out the entire background with a mixture of purple and black. Now let's make some shadows. For this part, I'm mostly using just wet paint without dipping my paintbrush into the water. I'm using a bit of purple and black for the shadows on the fruit. I simply outlined the bottom part of the fruit so it looks like it is sitting on the table surface. I'll be doing more shadows with the same mixture, so just follow along.
Thank you.
And it looks like we're done. Watercolors isn't really easy if you're starting out, so if your painting didn't come out how you wanted it to, you can always start the video up again and start your painting all over. It doesn't hurt to practice. And here it is without the tape. I hope you had fun painting with me today. That's it for now. See you next time.